tonight. Well, today's my talk is women inside STEM careers in Japan. I always put this word beyond the bias and barriers in front of my title of the talk. Yeah, because it's a kind of advertisement in NSF project Advance. Well, here I'll show the how low the ratio of the female researchers in Japan. Numbers of female researchers are increasing, but it's almost 12% at 2005, and now, last year, it's about 15.7%. It's the lowest among OECD countries. And our ratio of the female researchers are still low because of the reason is very low ratio in the companies and industry. That's only 8.2%. And in university, it's about 25% to 26%. So this is, yeah, it's a neck. Okay, and Japanese government's numerical target is 30% by 2020. It's 2 more years.
So,
okay, that's the first question, how we should do. Okay, today I give two kinds of talk. First, I will introduce the policies and measures of Japanese government for these 10 years and how changed the universities. That's first part. And the second part, I will show some activity of organization called EPIMUSE in Japan. We are called Renrakkai. And I'm completely involved with that work for almost 10 years or so. So, well, I'll mention about it precisely. Anyway, okay, government set, as I told you, one numerical target, 30% by 2020. A 30% of female ratio in leading position in all the areas in the society. So, and second, the government set two basic plans every 5 years, especially for STEM. Well, not only STEM, since 2005, 2010 and 2015, and now, yeah, it's in the fifth one. Those are the basic plan for science and technology. And the others is, this is also very important, the basic plan for gender equality. So this consists of the base for our movement. Okay, the three programs by next, from 2006 to present. And from the first one is supporting activities for female researchers, and also supporting positive activities for female researchers. This one, also called Kasoku program, which means accelerating program to increase, it's a kind of, well, affirmative action, including quota system. And the third one is, we call RTD fellowship, restart postdoctoral fellowship, the fellowship to be given for the researcher, including men, male scientists, from the child rearing. And first, this is common all over the world. We support female high school students into science. Okay, this figure shows the increase of female ratio of research in the STEM field. from 1985 to 2015. This is the line of the full professor. This is the assistant professor, and this is the lecturer. This is associate professor and lecturers and assistant professors. And this is research assistant. So higher the positions, lower the female ratio. And the lower the positions, you know, higher the female ratio. It's very clear. And our next program, government program, started here. So the rate looks a little bit, you know, steep, but still it's moving very gradually. Okay, from now on, I will show several, some example, good examples, and the supporting activities of female researchers. One is a common program among institutions. I will show these examples next. And the other good example is unique self-check system developed by Autonomous University. And after that, I will explain a CASOC program. It's a kind of quota system, a broad spillover effect in Kyushu University and Nagoya University. In the third, I will explain about RPD Fellowship, which is a fellowship in JSPS, and it starts from Child Care Link. Okay. Okay. This slide is very cute. This is the home page of Nagoya University Gender Equality Office, and I borrowed this one from Ms. Permission. And they have various programs for promoting gender equality. And first, they set gender equality office, then provide upstream programs or work-life balance issues for on-campus nursery or mentoring system and so on. And unique measure or unique system in Nagoya University is on-campus child care after school. That's very unique, and Nagoya University is the first one to have. And you can see various ones. They also, they got the award of 10 by 10 by 10 UN women as HIPOC. They will also have the big meeting next week, yeah, at Nagoya. Okay, this is, you cannot read this word, but this is the Excel sheet of Ochadai Index. And it's, you can get those from this, you know, URL. Anyway, they divided Ochadai Index, they analyzed the all kinds of basic condition for university to level the field for female scientists, so make easier working condition, and they list up all sorts of these, the 50 questions, and Ochadai, Autonomous University, distributed almost 100 sheets to all over the university in Japan, and they returned those, and they checked one question for 2 points, and average score is 62 points. But the highest is 80 points. This is very good, but the lowest is 17 points. And popular items selected, checked was, well, our university has a gender equality office, or we have homepage. Well, this sounds quite easy to do, but for example, it's a kind of seminar taking measures to prevent sexual harassment. Those are popular. Gets the item getting high scores, and they use the results. Well, Ojadai checked the points and returns their results without these kind of graph. And if this looks fast, that's you're going well. But if, you know, this is skewed, you know, you have to make effort for a certain point. So they make that kind of comment. So after receiving those kind of report, each university use those database-based evidence for the negotiation of the top. It's quite helpful. Also, doing the self-check and following the change over years, that's very good to keep the record on that program. Okay, this is Kasoku program, accelerated program. It's a kind of affirmative action. This is done by Kyushu University and is still continuing. Women called Women Researcher Promotion Program. And well, I explained the system. Well, they opened a position for the worldwide it's limited for the women. The position is limited women. And each also each department selected the applicant and candidates made the candidates A. The B department also made the candidates B and C and so on. And usually, I have been in this committee, in the higher committee for more than 10 years, so I was watching from the beginning. Yeah. And two steps, first selection and second selection. So this system has two steps. Not make, you know, so very nice researchers finally, you know, selected. And so as qualities of the candidates as well as motivation of the department are examined, if they are not interested in hire female scientists, you know, the candidates of this department could never, you know, selected. So, the committee members, especially from the outside, like me, check what the chairperson or department head is providing, saying after hiring her, what my department would do. They have to promise in front of the dean. So that works quite well and resulting the following result. This one. Here, from here, that system started. And then, you know, remarkably, the ratio numbers and the ratios increased. Because this is an old, big university, so the ratio of the female researchers is very, very low. But it's, for example, at the beginning, it's only 7.7%. That's very low. But now, it's 2015, it's increased 30.1, and now it's getting a little bit like that. Let's see, the important point of this figure is these are the female researchers selected under the this program. It's a kind of quota program, as I explained in the previous slide. And look at here. These are employed by outside quota, regular application. So once people or committee realize how female scientists good or excellent, they easily changed their mind, and they first realized we should hire more female scientists because they are good. So that's why these numbers get higher and higher. Okay, this is another university, Nagoya University. Nagoya University is doing a very good job, especially here. Especially Division of Biological Society, Graduate School of Science. Here, at 2006, when the program, next program started, Professor Ikue Mori was the only one professor for 10 years. Before that, Professor Michiko Go was only one professor for 10 years. So 20 years, only one professor in this department. But now, look, Professor Mori is, you know, sounded. 18 female scientists. Among those, three professors. So she said to me, three is a magic number. We can do anything if we have three female scientists in the professors' committee. Yeah. So they get very, she's originally a very active person, but gets more and more, much more active than before. Yeah. And this person is a research assistant professor and associate professor hired by under the quota system. But others are hired regular system. So you can understand how Nagoya University, especially this department, realized on the quality of the female scientists. Then, before that, many male professors told us there is no female scientists, good female scientists, because no one applied for the position. But quota system encouraged the female scientists to apply the position. That's a big change. Okay, this is RPD system, returning postdoc system. RPD system, as I told you, this is a fellowship system from the JSPS funding agency in Japan. So, and here, the applicants of the for 10 years and awardee. Yeah. So this is, you can understand, this RPD is also competitive, you know, fellowship. And from here, the numbers of the awardee, including the continued fellowship, is, see, from 30 to 200 this year, which means how government put the money for this system, and especially, yeah. And but problem also appeared, that is JSPS checked the job situation after 5 years of finishing RPD. Then this is RPD and this is PD. PD is a regular postdoc fellowship for postdoctoral. And you can see here and here, this responds to full-time researchers. And in the PD case, 90% of the awardee got full-time researchers after 5 years. But in RPD case, it's only 60%. And 10% with the postdoc, still doing postdoc. So very around 41, yeah, old postdoc, became older. And 10% is a part-time researcher. and another 10% part-time job. Mm-hmm. So after 5 years, let's see, this, you can understand easily what kind of program they have. So that's what we have, we can't forget, you know. Okay. Now, from now, I will talk about EpiMuse. We call Renrakukai, established at 202. It has a history of more than 16 years or so. It's a long name. It has originally long name. Since it is very long, we shortened the name to EpiMuse. Equal participation of the men and the women in science and engineering. And the association of this association has 90 academic societies in 2015. Now it passed hundreds this year. And what we do, the major roles, one, large scale surveys every 5 years. And important thing is this one, which I don't mention today, proposal and request to the government to do an annual symposium and surveys of female ratio in each societies and summer camp and so on. Okay, this is the homepage. And for example, this is a large-scale survey every 5 years, and we analyze it and report it, and those become base for the proposal and request to the government. Mm-hmm. Yeah, we have done quite a good job here. And for this one is a visibility search. I show just a... Okay, this is... These are the results of the... visibility is such, the female ratio of the scientists. For example here, president, vice president. Red indicates female, and blue the male. So you can understand how small fraction. No president, no president, no president, no president. These are the, you know. But the term of the president is, you know, 2 years or so. So there is a possibility to change this situation. And another point is, these are the student member, but these are the ordinary member. So, you know, you can realize the gap here. For example, physics, yeah, still there is a gap, yeah. Okay, this is this related to this unconscious bias, and this result is also included in an example 5 or 6 here. Yeah, I'll explain about it. Well, I come back this little bit later. Let's see. Question: are we visible enough in the scientific societies? We ask, yeah, speakers invited to symposium as a, in case organizer is men only, they invited female speakers only 10%. And if men and women are, you know, consists of one organized, work as organizers in one section, you know, 32%. This is the average, same as the average number of female ratio of the society. So, see what a big difference. We see unconscious bias everywhere. And nobody realized before we have done this research, nobody realized what, you know, we see these kinds of big difference. Okay, this is a large-scale survey in STEM every 5 years. And these results are based on the third survey, and you know, for respondents, around big numbers, and female, male, and female. And the contents of the reports are divided in this. There are various interesting points in every section, but chapter, but I focus child and nursing care today. Okay. This is number of children. We ask, how many children do you have? And this is the age distribution. And see, very quick. This one, around 40, you know, stopped in the female case. But male case, you know, they finally have, you know, they could have two kids, but you know, in female case, it's just a half of them. And here we ask, because it's so small numbers, and still two kids is not so many. So we asked the people, members, how many children would you like to have, if possible? And under 39, well, the first of all, they want to have at least two children, if possible. But under 39, male respondent answered 0.4. This is a real number. And this is 0.3 female case. So, but over 40, male has 1.5 kids and female has almost one kid. So this big difference is very serious. More than two children are desired, but it is difficult for younger generations in Japan at present. So we ask the reason why they do not have children. And for the male case, the financial matter, and the women's case, difficult to maintain a career and family. Okay, this is heavy family responsibility to women's side, because most of the women fears it's hard to do career as well as household. And just focus on the preschool, the male scientists or female scientists with preschoolers. And this is shows the hours per week in the lab. You know, this is a noise because they have to go home earlier. And in the main case, this doesn't change so much. And here, hours for household and child care per day at home. Here, this is big difference. For male, man case, husband case, this is, you know, 1.5 hours a day, but her spouse spent 4.5 hours a day, you know? So it's really heavy duty or responsibility to women's side. Okay, this one. So, why don't you take a child care leave? The rate is child care, the rate is increasing, but, you know, it's still very few. For example, a male scientist in university, this green means did not take leave. They don't get any child care leave. And here, female scientist in university, still, you know, blue market took leave as requested. Yeah, this gets, you know, for the kids in preschool to, these are older, this ratio corresponds to the whose kids are high school or over. So longer, 20 years difference, probably reside in between too. So younger generation is getting to take leave as requested. And some took leave, but not as requested in various reasons, and did not feel to be option. And here, this is cooperation. Cooperation is much more advanced in this sense. From here, younger generation, at this point, you know, it's they take label as required. So we ask why parents with preschooler did not take child care leave. And the major reason was workplace environment. So, you know, still they feel something hard to take child care leave. Especially for, you know, male and female too. Okay, we asked, what's the requirement of balancing family and work? And this one, workplace atmosphere or understanding from supervisor. These are always top in every four large-scale surveys, and especially women wants to these kind of women wants to work for a good atmosphere or understanding of the supervisor. In addition to that, for example, changing the male and female role or expanded after school care children and variety of provisions for leave of absence or and so on. Yeah. Major female scientists request more. Okay. This is, I have to explain a little bit. Dennis Normal, Mr. Dennis Normal is a writer of the science. You know the Journal of Science. And one day he asked me how the situation of the Japanese scientists. It's a 2005, 3 years ago. And at that time, it's a very big discussion in the government. We should throw out the numerical target or keep. Like, and the government side, especially CSTP, doesn't like numerical target. This is common opinion. Targets, numerical targets, have not had as much impact as we would like. Dr. Professor Yoko Harayama, a member of the council, told that to him. Well, he interviewed. So we said, without numerical target, we are afraid progress could stall. And he made a report on the science with 2 pages and put these pictures. He checked by himself. And this is a change of the frequency ratio of the this co-professor and assistant professor. So after hiring assistant professor, you know, still spillover is here. And you can understand this gets bigger and bigger along the years. So he pointed out the problem. Now finally, numerical target has been kept at that time. So still basic plan or most basic plan has numerical target, but after the next one, I don't know how it would be. Okay, this is a good sign of the results. We did 4 large scale survey, and this is a summary of the results of one question. We asked the member, what kind of job would you like to have? And we listed various jobs, but I picked out these 4. So, PI at, I want to be PI at university, in Ben's case, like this, around the ears. And I want to be PI at university, women scientist, PI scientist case. This, you know, gradually increasing. So this is, I think, very good sign and a big fruitful results of the next program, PASOK program, as well as basic program. So younger generation believes, since mixed or university or workplace helped them a lot, including RPD system, they believe they can do if we do well. I think they become to have confidence for doing the PA, becoming a PA. So I was very glad to see this result. And this is published in the reports of the cross survey last year. Yeah. It's published last year. All right. Okay. Now, Epimuse did a good work, I think. This one here. This is the unconscious. This leaflet is made for the understanding of unconscious bias. Actually, I didn't go into the unconscious bias today much. I just showed the visibility of female scientists in scientific society only, but there are so many biases. So please read these carefully, and you can look at your around. It consists of these contents. And since we published this one, this leaflet, we also have the Japanese one, and cabinet uses many times, so we have gender equality office in cabinet. So we send this leaflet more than 500 or something. And each university uses for instruction for the TOPSIN as a TOPSIN, and also its society too. Okay, this is a reference. Okay, thank you very much. Yeah. Mm-hmm.